New York Governor Andrew Cuomo. Thank you for being with us, Governor. Look, you were on this show yesterday, and you told Jim and I there will be more, and there are. What do you know at this hour?
Well, I think as we discussed yesterday, Poppy and Jim, and thank you for having me, the person was getting the desired effect, right? Getting the results they were looking for. They were causing terror. And if there was going to be one and then two and then three, there was going to be a pattern. I think we have several levels here. On the manhunt investigation and the ongoing drama and the two new packages today, I think they're making significant progress. I'm the former attorney general. I was a former prosecutor. I think the focus on Florida is going to bear fruit. Okay. I think he's done so many packages, or she has done so many packages. There's inevitably going to be DNA evidence or fingerprints. And I think that is going very well. And my instinct is they're going to have a result there on the specific on the manhunt. In terms of the bombs, there'll then be a back and forth. How sophisticated were the bombs? Were they supposed to explode? Were they supposed to intimidate? I think it's no one can say that they were fake bombs. These were dangerous devices that could explode. There may be a question of level of sophistication. I think we then have to look at what changes we make in the system. You know, in New York, we are constantly being attacked. It's a focus, it's a function of who we are, and we try to learn from them. We're going to focus here on New York, and I think the federal government should too, on the screening procedures for mail, both privately and the public system. But entities, governments, et cetera, need to do a better job on screening of the mail. But long term, look, this is a dysfunction of our democracy. This is a lesion on the body. And the question is, what is the virus causing that lesion? And we have to get to a point where you can have political debate without political violence. This is at a torrid level that is just unpalatable. And we're learning that. When you keep stirring that pot, and you have leaders, the president of the United States, people listen to him. He's no longer on a talk show. He's the president of the United States. And this is whipping up people, and you will see people respond. I think there's two tracks. Leaders have to be more responsible. And second, the American public has to demand that responsibility. They will not market if the American people do not buy, right? This is a great marketer in chief. If the American people don't buy, he won't sell. And that's true for every politician, by the way. They only sell what people buy. There have been changes in our society that were more culturally bottom-up driven. We have racial sensitivity we never had before. We have a sensitivity now about how we treat women in the workplace that we never had before. We need a new political sensitivity that says there are boundaries, and they are culturally driven and culturally imposed, and they are unacceptable. And if you step outside of that boundary, you will be condemned. I think there's too much emphasis on we want the president to stop, et cetera. It has to also be the American people. We need both. The president is hyper rhetorical, vulgar, et cetera. And when he gets on the stump and he wants to whip up a crowd, he uses language that is wholly inappropriate for a president to use. But I'd also like to see the American public sensitized and developed to the point where they say, we won't accept it. We're not buying it. And he will stop selling it.
Governor, just as you've been speaking there, we have a live picture of the containment vessel carrying that suspected explosive device. It's been going up slowly on its way up New York. It just stopped. Now it's going again. We were curious if there was a significance to that, but we'll continue to monitor. Governor, if I could ask you, you spoke to the president in the last day. Can you tell us about that conversation?
Yes. Look, I have political differences with the president. That is no secret. I've been vocal about it, so has he. What we did discuss was this investigation and what was going on with this investigation and how we need to work together and have the relevant law enforcement agencies work together seamlessly, tirelessly, and there can't be any dislocation between the federal and the state. And the president assured me, and it has come to be, the FBI, the Joint Terrorism Task Force, which is the main coordinating body, has worked with the state police, they've worked with local police. They have really been extraordinary. I believe the FBI has pulled out all the stops, the connection to Florida, the work they've done. I think that that was done extraordinarily well. I think that's one good thing to feel good about in this miserable situation is how well the federal, state, local forces all work together.
Governor Cuomo, we have just heard for the first time this morning since this news broke of these additional packages from the President of the United States. Let me read you his words in full. Quote, Republicans are doing so well in early voting and at the polls, and now this quote bomb unquote stuff happens and the momentum greatly slows. News not talking politics. Very unfortunate what is going on. Republicans go out and vote. That those are the first words, Governor, from the president on an attempted attack on the former director of national intelligence and on journalists at CNN and on New Jersey sitting Senator Cory Booker. Your response?
Look, it's just, it's wholly inappropriate. I believe the president never fully made the transition to the presidency. This is not a person who was in government before. He was not in public service before. He was in the entertainment business, the real estate business, the marketing business. I don't think he's ever fully appreciated the import of the office and the import of his position. And it always comes down to a competition and his politics, and he feels aggrieved. And I am sure that's how he sees this situation. He views it through a political lens. He's worried about the election. He wants to win the election, especially the Congress. He's focused on the Senate. And everything becomes political. And that then starts the anger all over again. We are in a destructive cycle. He doesn't like CNN. It's not, he voices against CNN. CNN winds up a target of these attacks. It's not a coincidence. There are no coincidences here. So should the president act more responsibly? Yes. Should he act less politically? Yes. Should he be more concerned with safety as opposed to electoral effect on some convoluted strategy? Yes. Am I hopeful that the zebra changes his or her stripes today? Mm-hmm. No. That's why I say track two, let's start talking to the American people and saying, we can't sustain this. We can't as a democracy. We have to be able to have debate and disagree. Mm-hmm. We're Democrats, we're Republicans, we're red, we're blue, but we are red, white, and blue. The day after the election, we're still America, and we have to function as one. I believe the American people are going to respond faster than the President of the United States.
It's a good point. It's a national responsibility. If I just before we let you go, Governor, you said at the top that you feel there's been significant progress in the investigation. You feel that there'll be a positive development on identifying who's behind this. I don't want you in public to get into details that you can't share, but I just wonder what you can say about what gives you that confidence and what has turned in the last number of hours, because as Poppy was saying earlier, yesterday we were hearing no hard leads, but now the language coming from law enforcement and yourself has changed. What can you tell us?
Well, every time there is a package sent, you have a new piece of evidence, right? And the FBI's ability and sophistication is so advanced. Every package, fingerprint, DNA, handwriting analysis, spelling analysis. So every package was a new piece of the puzzle. And they have sent out, or he has sent out, or she has sent out many pieces of the puzzle very quickly. Mm-hmm. You saw the shift to Florida. I think that's going to be a telling tale. And I think with all these pieces on the puzzle, we are going to get to a resolution of the puzzle on who it was. Mm-hmm. And that's going to be very good, and then people will relax. But my point is, when I say it's only the symptom and not the illness, what stops this from happening next week, or the week after, or the week after? And we can't sustain this. We just can't sustain it. So leaders change your behavior, yes. Okay, we don't think that's going to happen. Let's start talking to the American people and have a national dialogue about where we're going and what we're doing. And I believe the American people will get it faster than the leadership will get it. Look at how we changed on our racial discussion, on how we treat women, behavior in the workplace. In a matter of months, we've made dramatic progress on some of those issues. Let's change our political dialogue.